Hi, my name is Anne Lynn. I work at the University of Wisconsin in the College of Engineering. There, we work with the public to help them understand the science and engineering research happening in our college. Unfortunately, with social distancing, we can't interact with the public. So we've decided to make a series of videos with some of our activities that you can do at home with the people in your household. Today's activity is called Cutting It Down to Nano, and you can find a link to this activity in the description for this video, as well as a PDF link to this sheet. Today's activity is important because it helps students understand about size and scale, which was one of the main cross-cutting concepts in the next generation science standards, which is what teachers are using to teach kids about science and engineering practices. So understanding how small or big things are relative to each other is really important. So today, I'm gonna work with the two people I have access to with social distancing. Now normally, this activity is one that we do with kids in elementary school around second or third grade, all the way through seventh grade. At my house, I don't have any elementary or middle school students, so I volunteered my two teenagers. What you're gonna need is either the worksheet that you can print out from the PDF, and you can see, although the worksheet's in color, my printer is black and white, so that's why the sheet is black and white. Or if you don't have access to a printer, you can take a piece of notebook paper and just number it 0 through 27. You're also going to need some scissors, or for the kids, safety scissors. You guys get safety scissors. A ruler that you want to make sure has the metric system. So in science and engineering, we always work in the metric system, so you want centimeters on your ruler. You're going to want strips of colored paper that are approximately 150 millimeters by about 5 millimeters. This dimension isn't quite as important, but you want it to be pretty thin. I like to use different colors for the activity. And you need two for each person who's doing the activity. You'll also need some tape for this activity. So the first thing that we're going to do is have kids find something that is the smallest thing that they can bring back to your work area. So I'm going to ask Noah and Hannah to go find the smallest thing that they can right now. Depending on the age and, let's say, the creativity of the children that you're working with, you may want to set up some guidelines, or as we call them in engineering, constraints. For example, things like find an object that's inside the house, or something that belongs to you. Maybe things like make sure it's not sticky, or make sure that it's not alive, are things that you might want to consider. Now, if the kids are really little and they have trouble thinking of something that's really small, you could give them a series of objects that they could choose from, like a bean, or a grape, or a grain of rice, or some Legos maybe. That way they have things to choose from, but there's not too many decisions for them to make. So let's see what Hannah and Noah brought back for us. All right, Noah, what is the tiniest thing that you could find to bring us?
A Lego hand.
Hannah, what small thing did you bring for us?
An earring backing.
Oh yeah, that's really little. How big do you think that is?
Maybe half a centimeter.
Maybe half a centimeter? So one thing is that it's easy for us to understand things on a scale that we're used to working with all the time. For example, we use things like the kilometer to measure distance, like the distance across Wisconsin. We might measure meters to measure our own height. Scientists and engineers often use the nanometer. One nanometer is 1/1,000,000,000th of a meter. On this scale, we can measure things like the width of DNA or the size of computer chips. But this scale can be really challenging for us to understand. So I'm going to give Hannah and Noah each one of these worksheets, and I'm going to ask you to move your object just slightly out of the way. I'm going to use the one that I've numbered from 0 to 27. If you don't have a printer and you have to use a piece of paper that you wrote on, it can be helpful to look at the screen that has the PDF on it, because it has some nice illustrations of things at different scales. All right, so Noah, what color piece of paper would you like? You need two.
Blue and green.
All right, so I'll give you blue and green. Hannah, what would you like?
I'll take pink and yellow. Then.
Hannah will take pink and yellow. So we are dividing right along gender lines in our household here. And I will take blue and yellow. All right, so what you're going to do is you're going to take your first piece of paper, and I'm going to ask you to tape it right where the 0 is, all right? So go ahead and do that. I'll let you get your own tape. Again, depending on how old the kids are that you're working with, you might want to help them with the tape. I've worked with some kids that feel like they need to tape the entire strip down, which isn't really necessary. I'm going to assume that my high schoolers understand how to work with tape. Kind of iffy there, Noah, is that what you're saying? Cool. All right. Great, nice job. So with your second strip of paper, what you're going to do is you're gonna fold it in half like a taco so that the ends are together like that, see? Then you're gonna take your scissors and you're gonna cut it right at the fold, so you've cut it exactly in half. This represents one cut. So then you're gonna tape it right where it says number one. Now we're gonna continue to cut this smaller and smaller. At this point, once the kids understand the activity, you may wanna ask them, how many times do you think you can cut your piece of paper? How small do you think you can get it? Noah, how small do you predict based on what you know about size and cutting things? How small, how many cuts do you think you can make?
20.
Noah thinks he can make 20 cuts. Hannah, how many do you think you can make?
Maybe like 12.
12. Hannah says 12. I'm going to say that I can do 11. And so let's see how we do. One thing I recommend is as you fold and cut, that you tape each newly cut piece of paper. So you're going to tape one half to the piece of paper, to the worksheet, and then the other one you're going to cut in half. Things are going to get tiny really quickly, so if you tape as you go, you're less likely to lose your piece of paper. So let's all do that. One thing you want to be careful of is that nobody cuts themselves during this activity. As the kids are doing the cutting and taping, you can talk to them about the pictures on the worksheet, either on the computer screen or the worksheet that they're working on. You can talk about, for example, how the length of a pencil is 150 million nanometers. Human hair, the width of that is about 73,000 nanometers. A virus is usually around 72 to 150 nanometers. Getting down into these really small scales, we're actually smaller than a wavelength of light. So most light is around here, between 300 and 600 nanometers. So when we get smaller than light, it can be really tricky because we can't use a microscope to see these things. Depending on the age of the kids and whether or not they've used microscopes before and if they know anything about light, this may or may not be something that you choose to talk with them about. You can also ask the kids to take the smallest object they found. So Noah, your Lego hand, and Hannah, your earring. Why don't you measure those and see where they fit relative to the paper that you cut up. So Noah, how many times were you able to cut your sheet?
Only 7.
Oh, not 20, huh?
No.
Well, you know what? If you look at this, that makes sense. 20 is just slightly larger than the size of a virus, so...
That's pretty small.
That's really small. I don't think you would have been able to cut it. Hannah, how about you? How far were you able to cut?
I got to 8.
8, that's pretty good. That makes sense, too. You and I have both said around 10 or 11, which is the width of a human hair. It'd be pretty tricky to cut something that small. What? Why couldn't you cut it smaller? What was challenging?
Well, the scissors would have gotten too big after a little while.
Yeah, so the blades of the scissors, they're too large to cut the paper,
yeah,
right?
They're too thick.
Yeah, they're too thick. What else was challenging, Hannah?
Holding the paper.
Holding the paper was challenging? Yeah. At this point, you could have a conversation about the tools that scientists have to use in order to work on these much smaller scales. Scientists are really good at figuring out ways to work with things like viruses and DNA, and so they have specialized tools. You can have a conversation about what kind of tools might help us cut the paper smaller. So, Noah, since cutting it was hard, what do you think we could use to cut the paper even smaller?
Maybe a single-bladed thing, like a box cutter or a knife?
A box cutter or a knife, or a razor blade, maybe. Yeah, those are excellent ideas. And Hannah, what could we use to maybe hold it when it got really small?
Maybe some kind of tweezers?
Tweezers, yeah, because that's used to hold really small things. And so if we had those tools, we might be able to cut it smaller. I have some tweezers here, and you could get some at your house as well and see if you could hold the paper and maybe cut it with a knife or a razor blade. I recommend that you have an adult do this, not having the kids cut the paper at that point, but to see if maybe you could cut it at least one more time. So that's our activity for today. I hope that you found it useful and that it's something you can do at home. Check back with us because we're going to continue to make videos of things that we can do at home. And I know Hannah and Noah are super excited to be able to continue to do science videos with me. Thanks! So normally this is an activity that we do with kids. The link to this worksheet is in the comment section. Not the comment section?
Description.
In the description for the video. Do I have to start again? So I think you want to cut now? I'm wearing my DNA socks.